I think I hit the right button. Welcome back, Tim Ostendorf here, innkeeper and baritone, usually to discuss all things Joan Sutherland. But tonight I'm trying something a little different. Well, you know, I've mixed it up. I played a little Sills and I played a little Gruberova, and I just did a video a little over a week ago of one of Cleopatra's arias from Julius Caesar by Handel, Da Tempeste, one of her last arias in the third act, and she thinks Julius Caesar might have died, but he didn't, and she's all excited, and just like the tempest of the storm, it's so wonderful when the warriors come back through the storm or something like that. But it's not about that. It's about the wonderful pyrotechnics of the vocality of the sopranos in question. And so this you must watch after you've watched my Joan Sutherland version of the same aria. But a few things before we get into the music. And you'll notice, you can't see the windows here, but we've changed the clocks ahead, so it's light out, so it's kind of confusing. But it's okay. It's still okay to have a little cocktail. And tonight's cocktail is brought to you by Smuggler's Notch Vodka in Vermont. Smuggler's Notch. Beautiful bottle, isn't it? I hope they don't mind me plugging them. I can't imagine they wouldn't mind a little free advertising, you know what I'm saying? But there's a group of college friends that stay with us every year. They're a wonderful group of girls, four girls. Dawn, Courtney, Jody, and Jess. And Dawn Elliott, her husband, her husband and father-in-law, Ron and Jeremy Elliott, started this wonderful distillery. It's one of the smoothest vodkas you'll ever want to try. So it's in your local New Hampshire liquor store, and I hope it's all over the country. So there's my little plug about that. And I think I have time to get this done before the next version of RuPaul's Drag Race starts tonight. It's not till 9 Eastern Standard Time on the Loco Channel. See what happens tonight. It'll be very exciting. Hopefully Jinx Mansoon will... Mansoon? Who's that? Jinx Mansoon, who lives out in Seattle, actually, the reason I'm going to be playing Beverly Sills singing this aria tonight is a friend of mine out there in Seattle, Mr. John Carroll. Hi, John. Told you I'd mention you. Hello. We're friends on Facebook. We've been friends through friends, and we've actually known each other for probably close to 20 years now. Can you believe it? And anyway, we're friends on Facebook, but we've known each other before and, you know, whatever. And so through Facebook, we both have joined this group called the Beverly Sills Crazies. And they are crazy, let me tell you. In a good way. I don't mean any disrespect. But anyway, he had talked about this aria, and I said, well, if you want to hear Joan's version, and her wonderful ornaments, and blah, 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 and he sent me a separate message, and then he said, you know, it would be really fun if we could figure out Skype, and figure out how to do, like, I could have a guest star. Like, no. We have some commentary from Mr. John Carroll, straight from Seattle, Washington. Something like that, right?
That's where Seattle is, isn't it? I hope so. Boy, I sounded really stupid for a moment.
Anyway, I went a little more casual tonight. I don't even know what this Lucky brand is. I think I got it for a Christmas gift one year. It's a just a little long-sleeve t-shirt. But you can't see my belly, so it actually makes it look like I work out. So that's why I thought I'd wear it a little casual tonight. And let's see what else. I probably should get to the music, right? So here's Beverly Sills. Now, I mentioned I loved Joan Sutherland's ornaments on the second verse. You know, it's a da capo aria. It starts da capo from the head. So you do, it's an ABA. You do the first section, then you do the second section, then you do the first section again. And Joan Sutherland's version is amazing in all these high notes, and it's great. Beverly Sills' version, which is amazing, you don't even know when it gets to the first repeat of the first verse again. You don't even know, like, what world would... Suddenly it's like completely different aria. You can't even... practically can't even tell. Anyway, and this was the role that I mentioned last week, how it catapulted her to fame as the queen of New York City opera. And this was the recording with her and Norman Traigle and Maureen Forrester and Beverly Wolfe. It's a great recording. It caused, now causes quite a bit of a stir, I suppose, over the past 20 or so odd years with all the historically informed performances and things like that. That, you know, they placed arias in different parts, and they rearranged things, and you know, the aria that was supposed to be in the first act and now in the third act, and they kind of screwed with it as far as that goes. So it was kind of, for everyone who wants everything to be as traditional as possible, it was quite a scandal, I guess, to have this recording. For example, Norman Traigle, who was a wonderful bass, in one of the most recent Opera News, there's a wonderful article about him. I think it's written by Iris Siff. I could be wrong, but anyway, about his demons and, you know, his different problems he had over the years. And he didn't have a huge recording career, but the few recordings definitely seek them out. His Blitch in Susanna with Phyllis Curtin is amazing. This recording, even though he's singing what should have been a castrato role, you know, the men who got a little snip there, and is now most often, sometimes is sung by a countertenor or a mezzo-soprano, but anyway, it's sung by a bass in this recording. So anyway, do some research, find out more about it. If you like the music, seek it out, and I'm just going to get to the music. I'm going to stop babbling, okay? Here we go. Section, but just as a comparison between my two little divas here, Joan and Beverly, Joan's recording clocks in at 5 minutes and 35 seconds. Beverly's clocks in at 4 minutes and 59 seconds. That's a 36 seconds difference. That's huge if you think about it. Mainly because Sills, as I think was in Times Magazine, said, the fastest voice alive. And so a lot of her recordings, if you compare them with Joan's, a lot of times their timing is very different, with Beverly's being much faster and much more elaborate. And I will say one somewhat annoying thing about this booklet. Okay, here, Julius Caesar, blah, 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 you know, the cast list, there we go. But you have to flip through the whole act one, act, like the whole thing, in like three different languages before you get to the tract list. I prefer a little booklet to have the track list, like almost like to page two. There it is. It's great. So much easier. Of course, I'm so old fashioned, like CDs are probably on their way out. Everyone has their iHooha and things like that, and they download thing off the interwebs and the Webernets and whatever. I like my CDs. I'm like those old queens with their records and vinyls and things like that. So here's the B section of Cleopatra's third act aria with a comparison of Joan Sutherland. Maybe, I wonder if you could open up two YouTube videos side by side to do like a total side comparison. I'll have to work on that. That would be fun.
Oh,
Although I think her, Beverly's B section is actually a little slower than Joan's, but much more ornamented, which is kind of unusual. Here we go for the B section. I wish I had a score to follow along. I should get the score to this because it's like it's a completely different... Well, listen to it. I mean, that part sounds the same. The orchestra. Talking about the vocal part. It's coming up in a second. Barely hear it. I'm not saying I don't like it, but woo! So anyway, there's Beverly Sills doing the aria that we heard last week, Da Tempeste from the third act of Giulia Cesare by Handel, just what like I said, I wish I had them side by side that I could, someday I'll figure out all the technical stuff, and I'll get my friend John, and we'll do some Skype thing, and he'll be a guest, and it'll be fun, and he'll be here, and like, it'll be, but like, he's right here, or maybe I'll just get on a freaking plane and go out, and, well, I mean, I'd love to see John, but I really want to see Jinx Monsoon. That would be a blast, you know what I'm saying? So, anyway, and what I think would also be interesting, because this is the story about Phyllis Curtin, who is supposed to have that role, what would she have done with it? I'm sure it would have been completely different, and maybe I'll play a little Phyllis Curtin sometime. I don't really have a lot of stuff to overlap, although, actually, I have Joan Sutherland and Beverly Sills and Phyllis Curtin all singing Depuis les jours. What's that French aria? You know. I'll talk about it next time. And that would be fun. That would be a fun comparison because it's kind of short aria. Okay, have a good night. And happy daylight savings because now it's a whole new world with lots of light later at night. Oh, that was fun. All right, have a good night. Bye.